Alright. Hello, everyone. I'm back here in Lord of the Rings, Realms in Exile, CK3 mod, to show you all the new little updates that they've been putting out. So, right now, this is an open beta. There's going to be things that aren't exactly, what's the word? Not exactly implemented yet, slash, there might be some broken placeholder text and whatnot. I don't know if I'll encounter it much over here, but I know it's over, like, over here somewhere in the other mountains. So, I was doing some investigation on my own time, and I discovered Gloin and Gimli over here in... they are in the kingdom of Dane Ironfoot, if you all remember him. Let's see, I'm just clicking into my tabs here so I don't forget stuff. Okay. Yes, so Gloin is banned Gloin, son of Durin, and his heir is Gimli Durin, son of Gloin. Or I guess Gimli, son of Gloin, house Durin. I think that's how that works, because dwarf names. He's only 120 here. I think when the fellowship starts, he's like 150? No, maybe he's older than that. Because Gloin has, like, white hair and some section. I'm only 216 here. Okay, so dwarves have a lot of interesting features in this mod. They have, you can do expeditions, which if I go to activities, I can do Dwarven Expedition, establish a realm in a previously abandoned hold, which basically is, in the Crusader Kings 3 vanilla game, if you're doing the Norse, they can do Scandinavian Adventures, I think that's what they're called. And you can basically take your entire realm and move to another area. That's basically what this is. So if I wanted to establish, let's say, I wouldn't do this because I know what is over there. So I'm going to move, let's say I took my realm. My little 827, that's not bad. My little 827 area, and I moved it over to, let's say I moved it over here, like in the mines of Moria. I wouldn't do this because the mines of Moria are dangerous. But there's actually the Hall of Durin somewhere around here. I saw it earlier. I was looking. Just do stuff. Yeah, here it is. The Doors of Durin. So if I wanted to, like, move my realm all the way over here, I could do that. I don't want to because... there's a lot of orcs over here that hate my dwarven flesh. So there's a band of orcs there. There's a band of orcs there. There's these creepy guys over here who worship the Balrog, I think. but then there's also Balin, and Balin's digging through the mines, and we all know how that turns out. So yeah, that's what Dwarven Adventures are. I could also move him, like, somewhere else into the Northern Mines, I think that's what these are, the Northern Mountains. But the problem is, there's dragons. So, it's not great. I don't know if the dragons are actually implemented, but I know for a fact that there's dragons up here. There's technically dragons over here. There were dragons over here, but we killed those guys. Okay, so that's Dwarven Adventures. There's also Mining Expeditions, where you can grab your best pickaxes and go underground, digging up great bounties from Middle Earth that is hidden beneath the surface. No. So it's not a lot of money, because I'm a dwarf. I think dwarfs get discounts doing this stuff. As you can see, it's pretty cheap doing like hunts and dwarven expeditions and mining expeditions. Pilgrimages are cheap. If I was going to play as an elf, it's like double that. Except they can't do these two. Or they can, I guess they can do this if you have a smith, but they can't do the dwarven expedition. In terms of decisions for the house for Gloin and Gimli and all them, they don't really have much because they're not kings. They're just Gloin is a lord. Gimli is not even a lord. You can't play as Gimli unless you land Gimli, but you wouldn't do that because he's technically your heir. I mean, I guess you can, but there's really no point. And with the ring not implemented, he's not going to leave for the fellowship. So, well, I don't think I'm going to die anytime soon. Right, so that's that. I can marry. I don't know if Gloin actually has. They don't really talk about it. They don't. The book came out so long ago. And even like the extended stuff, they didn't really, like Christopher Tolkien didn't talk about Gloin's wife or Gimli's mother or stuff like that. Because they were so focused on, the ring and other things like that. So we'll just, and then Gimli's eye married. Okay, well, that's good to know. I can create Kadib branch, I can petition, okay, blah, 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 blah. Oh, I need people. I need lots of people. Why is my court so small? Oh, you're expensive. Okay, well, I'm gonna need more people. Who are you? Where are you? Oh, you're all the way over there. Which isn't too bad. Because you're still part of Erebor? No. I'm here. You're all the way over here. Yeah. Okay. You're brave, callous, and impatient. Low. It's because I'm old. Oh, they also have the crafting thingamajigs, which you can take. I think only dwarves get access to this, which gives you a whole bunch of other stuff. They give you exactivation focus. Excavation focus, enrichment focus, or artificing focus, which gives you learning, knight effectiveness, or you can have more learning and more court grandeur. Doesn't really matter to me because I'm not really a king. Or you could have stewardship and prowess. So that's interesting. And then that gives you other things like that's actually really interesting. I don't think I need any of this right now because I don't know if I'm actually going to be doing any delving. I also don't know how much it is implemented, so we'll just go to this, maybe complete this out here. Because more money is nice, especially for a dwarf. Some reason my music stopped playing. There we go. Oh, good. A little lore bit here. I was born among the children of Mahal, adopted children of Ur, steadfast dwarves. Her father shaped us in dark times and such harder than men, more resistant to illness and corruption. We are long-lived, slow to bloom. We consider our youths to be more than children, no more than children of the majority of 40. Oh. Appropriate age to marry, and that is an appropriate age to marry before the age of 70. Okay, that makes sense. Those both genders wear beards since birth, and a dwarf without a beard is a mockery of judgment and shame. Actually, that's very similar to Dungeons & Dragons. For those who don't know, if your dwarf in Dungeons & Dragons doesn't have a beard, you're looked on upon with shame. It depends on the DM. I'm not particular about that. If your dwarf doesn't want to have a beard, you don't have a beard. Khazad-dûl, our sacred language, devised for the Maker himself, is never spoken in front of dwarves and reserved for ancient lore and solemn gatherings. Okay. Every day we adopt the language of our closest neighbors and business partners. We do not fear the sun like the orcs. We are most comfortable beneath ground, where we carve in the halls of living rock. And a sister's strength. I see. Where did all these people come from? He should be there. He's my marshal. Not a lot of good folks over here. Play your family was eviscerated. This is Thorin's brother. Sister. Thorin's sister. Right? Yeah. Thorin's sister. Interesting. I didn't know Thorin had a sister. Huh? More you know. Is it actually lore accurate to his death in this mod? Slain in battle, yep. Perfect. It doesn't say who slayed him. Well. Good to know. I'm Dane's marshal. He wouldn't make me his stewardship.
Oh, okay.
So they also have artifact crafting in this mod, which is very interesting. I don't know how to use any of this. I've tried it before and it didn't really work. Because you need minerals, and then you apply the minerals to the modifiers, and then you can craft it, and it takes a number of days. It's a cool feature. I don't know how to use it. That's such a good perk, but you have deceitful. I don't like that. Boof. Yeah, you lose prestige at some rate for that. I love that he's right next to her. Yep, so Dane controls the mountains of Erebor, or the castle of Erebor. And then right next door, or right outside basically, is the kingdom of Dale, owned by the king. King Bane of Dale, son of Bard. Jeez, that's far away. So far away. Dane is making his grand tour. Greedy. Great. Well, they got Gimli right. Content, stubborn, gregarious. Brilliant strategist, I need to leave him there. Jeez. Why would I do this? He's not doing this. That's strange. He's enough to reroute now. Why doesn't he spend it? Oh. Oops, I didn't want to do that. Well, did anyways. I don't know if I want to do that or not. These are expensive troops. Expansive. This yet? Nope. What's going on now? Why is he... not even. He's above ground. Oh, that's annoying. I didn't want to do that then. He's gonna get stomped. I can't join that war. That's fine. It's fine. That's a lot of troops. Why is she trying to claim it didn't belong to her anyways? Weird. Weird. I mean, I did, because the feudal government, cadet branches and feudal governments are great. Well, that's an interesting art. Primacy of Alur. Minor trait is seen as pious. Okay. Oh. How very interesting. Mine away. Okay. Yeah. My spear, my armor is like Renfold shields, my teeth are swords, my claws are spears, the shield of my tail is a thunderbolt, my wings are a hurricane, my breath is death. Smog rays. This one has a duchy place, interesting. These people worship dragons? These orcs worship dragons? Jeez. What do I got? Anything? Jeez. You can actually craft things. Okay, so. How far? Oh, this is. This can get expensive. But also, probably dangerous. Digging deeper means finding things that are better less left hidden. Dwarves are so expensive. wonder what that is. One of these. Maybe that's a placeholder type. Oh, that's expensive. Bro, you're disloyal. I don't want you. Oh, let's place a little text. Okay. I don't think I can settle above ground, right? vastly superior. Interesting. A lot of these have different traits. Corrin the Old. Could build up there. What is this castle? Castle of Barlamanis? Barad Marcus. Barad Marcus. Quite a stretch from my own area, but could do it. Okay, so there's Moon Realm. Then there's Satellite Hole. Oh, how interesting. Oh, that's a lot of problems. I still want to do that, but I don't want to do this. Cancel all that. That's just so bad. Yikes. There was another mine over here somewhere. Did I see that? Over here? No, no, no. Back up again. You know when it does this. Go back to this, Satellite Hold. Caleb Doom. That's 182. Caleb Doom. Where is this? It's right there. Gelbuldum. We're next to this creepy guy. Gosh, there's a lot of mines. And that's right in the heart of problem territory. There's nothing you can give me. Why do you keep doing this? Strange creatures? Ooh. Our settlers tell tales of strange creatures that move and shatter. Oh, that sounds very similar to, oh, what are those things that are hardly talked about? They talked about in the Silmarillion during their, oh, I can't remember the names. The things that dwell deep, deep within the mines. Okay, so that would still cost an arm and a leg to do. Yeah. Got it. I'll stay here. Oh, is this lake down? That's a doom, which is weird. Oh, whatever. Ballin is dead, or not dead. It's probably removed somewhere. He's up there. He's in this corner. Well, that's some good views for him, I guess. Because he didn't succeed in Moria. Slash was probably kicked out by the other orcs. That's the problem with his placement. Is if you don't set it up right in time, you'll get steamrolled by this band here. Unless, I guess, if you excavate the doors of Durin, you could probably... maybe. Oh, Elrond. That's cool. Hi, Elrond. Aragorn. Everything's so far away. Yeah, he controls all of that. Ooh, is he trying to make a push into the mine? Into the mountains here? Yeah, he is. Okay, good. He's pushing Erebor along the ridge here. I mean, he could easily take the mines. Because he has. That's Dale. 4,000 troops. He has so many troops. I don't know this guy. Nain. Wife's plotting against my spy master? Why? Speaking of which, do I have any? No, I don't. Does Gimli? Okay, so I need metal. Metal, metal, metal. I mean, it's why I might as well use the feature that it has. High divinely chaotic. Welcome to the stream. I am a dwarf and I'm digging a hole. Got something in my eye. Ah! Oh, hi. That was Gimli. I have like five kids because my wife is pumping them out. Gimli has two. My heir is Gimli, his heir is probably the oldest, which is Sindri. Because Gimli is like 132, and the next below him is the guy who's 7. So. Now, Gimli has content, stubborn, and gregarious. He's a brilliant strategist, and he's an unyielding defender. So he is Gimli. Gimli's stubborn. Gimli is gregarious, and Gimli is sometimes content. Ooh, I got a lucky pickaxe. Aha! And then, of course, Gloin is greedy, wrathful, and impatient, which is Gloin. I'm a dwarf, I like money. Give me your money. When you got gems, give them to me. Gib, gib. Yeah, exactly. Money now. It's Yeah, I think the rare. Oh, this keeps kicking in. The metals. We got mithril, gold, silver, steel, iron, bronze, copper, tin, lead. Mithril being the highest because mithril be good. Did I get anything from that? No, I didn't. Oh, I got silver. Ah! It's gonna take me 210 days to build an axe. 210. Why? Yeah, it is terrible. 210 days. Oh, I need the trait Smith to even attempt it. Oh my god. Well, you know what? I got the time. Time goes fast in CK3. I think 210 days in real time is like that's several months. It means you have to go down to the blacksmith every day, or almost every day, and be like, is it done yet? And the blacksmith will be like, no, no, you still got 7 months to go. Denethor's still alive. Okay. Théoden's still alive. I'm moving up for some reason. I don't want to move up there. Oh, it uses up the metal when I build. Oh, no. Oh. Oh, I failed to craft it. Oh, it doesn't use it up. Oh, thank God. Okay, so I have Smith. So now I can do stuff with. Specialize it. Oh, how interesting. Why am I challenging this person? No. I'm gonna challenge a woman to a duel. You're a fornicator, I don't like you. You're also a human. Bye bye. So stupid. Thank you. Oh, I'm sure there's a. Well. Actually. If I recall, I would try to rack my brain for a minute for about Bannerlord. I think there might be a Lord of the Rings mod for Bannerlord. I don't know if it was in the works or if it's already out. I haven't played Bannerlord. I have it. I just haven't downloaded it. It's like 40 gigs, I think. Stress. Alright, I'm getting stressed. Actually, I wonder if Manowar would even run on my PC. It might. I might need a new processor, though. I need a new processor. Money be tight, though. Yeah, that's true. Bannerlord definitely has more to it, I guess, because you get to control the fights. You get to actually fight instead of like CK3 like, where you don't have to control the fights, I guess. Food is joy. Food. Yeah, it's a different type of game, I guess. Because this one is more, I mean, obviously, Crusader Kings 3 is a lot like, you know, Civilization and other, and there's another game I'm thinking of that I can't remember. It's all dialogue options. And Bannerlord is like, oh, what the heck is it? Can't remember the game. Total War. It's like Total War, but in first person. There used to be a Lord of the Rings Total War. I think it was called War of the Ring or something like that. It was on like Xbox 360 and PS3. Stop offering this. I don't have anything to ask for, Dane. These poor peasants, 57 people against 4,000 dwarves. We're against tyranny. Oh God. Oh, I don't know if you saw this, divinely, when I showed it earlier, but there is It's over here somewhere. There's Moria and the Doors of Durin. I will find it. It was over here. It was slower. Give me a moment. It's over here somewhere. Everything's so small. Yeah, here it is. It's the Doors of Durin. The only way to get access to this is if you do, it's easier if you're over here, but if I wanted to gain access to this, I'd have to do a Dwarven expedition. I could either move my entire realm, which I don't really want to do, or I could make it a client state, and then I'd have to basically travel, that's roughly, but yeah, as you can see, it would take maybe 182 gold, and I'd have to cross about 30 different dangers to get over there. But yeah, there's like little stuff there. That's actually really nice. There's little building. Moria is ice. So this is Durin's Hall. I guess this is all Moria. I don't know if it has like the whole like a special building for Moria. It's the Miramir. That's interesting. Yeah, so that's really cool. If you play as Balin, I think that's the name. You get a option to either disable or enable the Balrog, because if you enable it, you have a 1% chance of basically killing it or defeating it. If you don't defeat it, you'll die. Or you can disable it and not worry about it. Yeah. Person wants the mines? Why? Go away. They don't belong to you. only 23. Sure. I wonder if I got access to that because I found silver. Interesting. It is. Cool. This phase two, good man. Ooh, more stewardship, man. More money. These guys still at war? they're fighting each other. Okay. Yeah. Oh, I finally got the axe. Weapon artifact.
Thank you.
Well, I think I'm gonna stop there for right now. It's about noonish. I got things to do, technically. But yeah, this was the little showcase of what the Realms in Exile have been doing. I'll either go back to this next time, or I'll go back to the Game of Thrones stuff. We'll see what happens. But yeah, thanks for everyone who was